Good morning everyone. Today we will discuss about what happens when the yarns burn. Yes, what happens when the different types of yarns burn? Do they shrink away from the flame or do they melt, or what type of odor they give? So we will discuss with the help of different types of fibers. So first of all, we will discuss about the cotton fibers. Yes, cotton fibers, which are obtained from the fruits of the cotton plant. Yes, on burning, the cotton fibers do not melt and do not shrink. Yes, they do not melt and do not shrink. And on burning, they give a smell, they give the odor like a burning paper. Okay, so on burning, they give the odor like the burning paper. Now, our next one is wool. Wool is an animal fiber. It is an animal fiber that is obtained from the fleece of different animals like sheep, goat, camel, yak, rabbit. Okay, so on burning, the wool do not melt, but it shrinks away from the flame. Yes. On burning, it do not melt but shrink away from the flame. And on burning, it gives a smell like a burning hair. It gives a smell like a burning hair because actually wool is an animal fiber, which is the fleece of the animals. Now next one is a silk. Silk is also a animal fiber, which is obtained from the cocoon of silkworms. Yes, cocoons of silkworm. So on burning silk, this silk, it do not melt but it shrink away from the flame. It shrink away from the flame, do not melt and then burn. And on burning, it gives like a smell like a charred meat. Okay. Now, our synthetic fibers. Synthetic fibers are those which neither obtained from plants nor from animals. They are made from the chemicals. Okay. So, when we burn the synthetic fibers, they shrink as well as melt. Yes, they shrink as well as melt. And on burning, they give the smell like a burning plastic. So, they give the smell like a burning plastic. So, on the basis of that, we can find out the qualities, the properties of different fibers. Now, we will discuss about different steps from cotton plant to cotton shirt. Yes, we will discuss about different steps from cotton plant to cotton shirt. Black soil and warm climate. Black soil and warm climate is good, or you can say is must, for growing of cotton plants. Okay, and when the cotton plants grow, it becomes mature, its fruits burst open, and when the fruits burst open, we can see the cotton wool. We can see the cotton wool with seeds. At this time, these are the cotton wool with seeds. Now, the seeds are separated from the cotton wool through the process of ginning. The seeds are separated from the cotton wool. Now, this cotton wool, which is a fiber, it is twisted together to form the cotton yarn. And this process of converting cotton wool into cotton yarn, it is known as spinning. And this spinning can be done with the help of the machines as well as with the help of the hands. Okay, like the simple devices like the kli and charkha can be used to do the process of spinning. Now, this cotton yarn converted into cotton fabric. Yes, through the process of weaving, we can convert cotton yarn into cotton fabric. Weaving, what is weaving? Weaving is a arranging of two sets of yarn together at right angle to each other. So, through the process of weaving, we can convert cotton yarn into cotton fabric, and this is done with the help of the looms. The weaving is done on the looms, maybe the hand looms or maybe the power looms. Now, with the help of the machine, with the help of the swing machines, cotton fabrics, we can, with the help of the cotton fabrics, we can stitch the cotton shirt. So, these are the different steps from cotton plant to the cotton shirt. And different processes are there, like the process of ginning, process of spinning, and the process of weaving. Now, we will discuss about different steps from jute plant to jute bag. Yes, we will discuss about different steps from jute plants to jute bag. Okay, jute plant is mainly cultivated during rainy season. It is mainly cultivated during rainy season. And when the plants at the, it is, its stems are harvested at its flowering stage. The stems of the jute plants harvested when the flower, when the plant is at its flowering stage. Because we get the jute fibers from the stem of the jute plants. Yes. So, at the flowering stage, the stems are harvested and soaked into water. The stems are harvested and soaked into water at least for 15 to 20 days so that they can grow. Yes. Now, after the 15 and 20 days, these stems are rooted by hands. And this process is known as retting. And after the process of retting, fibers are separated from the stem. So, after the process of retting, we will get the jute fibers. Now, these jute fibers through the process of spinning converted into yarn. They will convert it into jute yarn. Jute yarn, and after that jute yarn, after the process of weaving, they will convert it into jute. They will convert it into jute fabric. Now this jute fabric, which is not so smooth, okay, it is used for making your bags and mattresses with the help of the swing needle. So these are the different steps which is included from the jute plants to jute bag. After the process of retting, after the process of weaving, and after stitching them, we will get the jute.